السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أهلا بكم في أول محاضرة من English for Non-Specialists. In this week we are going to start the book with page 2. Starting from exercise D, the underlined words are in the wrong sentence. Write the correct word for each sentence. واتكلمنا في المحاضرة إن في الإكسرسايز دوات عايزنا نعرف معاني المفردات اللي تحتها underline ونشوف الأوبزيت بتاعها إيه من المفردات اللي في from 1 to 6. For example 1, my boss is emotional. He doesn't care about any pain he causes to other. هنا emotional محطوطة في سياق خاطئ. الصح إن هي تكون ruthless اللي في رقم 5. فهنكتب هنا في المكان الفاضي My boss is ruthless. He doesn't care about any pain he causes to other people. يبقى إجابة number 1 هي ruthless. Number 2, she is being aggressive about her exam results. We don't know if she passed or failed. The opposite of aggressive اللي هي معناها عدواني أو عدائي هي secretive بالضبط اللي في رقم 3. يبقى هنطلع اللي في رقم 3 تكون هي مكان رقم 2. فالجملة كاملة هتبقى She is being secretive about her exam results. يعني متكتمة أو كتومة. We don't know if she passed or failed. Number 3, if you disagree with him, he will just argue back. He can be very secretive and it's very unpleasant. طبعا هنا secretive برضو في السياق خطأ. الصح ان احنا نحط aggressive مكانها. فأجريسيف هنا معناها عدواني أو عدائي. فالجملة كاملة هتبقى If you disagree with him, he will just argue back. هو هيرد عليك وهيناقشك بحدة. He can be very aggressive and it's very unpleasant. Number 4, he is very materialistic about his work. He always finishes everything off before he goes home. هنا materialistic برضو في السياق خطأ. الصح ان احنا هنحط مكانها conscientious اللي في رقم 6 يعني دقيق وواعي لمواعيده. Number 5, the bride got very ruthless at the wedding. She cried when she left off for her honeymoon. طبعا هنا ruthless يعني عديم الرحمة او عديم الشفقة اللي احنا حطناها مكان emotional في 1, لكن هنا أنسب إجابة هي emotional. فهتكون الجملة صحيحة هي The bride got very emotional at the wedding. She cried when she left for her honeymoon. Number 6, all she talks about is money. She's become so these days. أنسب إجابة هنا هي materialistic يعني مادي. تمام. وبكده تكون الإجابات هي Number 1, مكان emotional هيبقى ruthless. Number 2, مكان aggressive هتبقى secretive. Number 3, مكان secretive هيبقى aggressive. Number 4, مكان materialistic هيبقى conscientious. Number 5, مكان ruthless هتبقى emotional. Number 6, مكان conscientious هيبقى materialistic. في exercise E بيقول لي circle the adjective which describes how each person feels. ففي exercise دوت بيعلمك how to express your emotions and to feel the exact word for each sentence to your direct emotion. Number 1, I can't believe you took the money without asking. ها ايه الايموشن اللي طاغي على الجملة دي او الشخص اللي قال الجملة دي اكيد كان حاسس بايه؟ delighted ولا furious غضبان؟ furious غضبان جدا. Number 2, wow that's amazing, did you really do it yourself? ها impressed يعني منبهر ولا reckless يعني لا يبالي؟ بالضبط impressed منبهر. Number 3, I'm not saying it'll be easy but I'm sure we can manage it. Offended يعني حاسس بإهانة ولا positive إيجابي؟ بالضبط إيجابي. Number 4, thank you very much for helping me with my car. It was very kind of you. amazed يعني منبهر، ولا grateful يعني حاسس بالامتنان والشكر. بالضبط grateful. Number five, that will never work. It's much too complicated and we don't have enough help. ده استحالة يقدر ان هو يشتغل او يصلح او يؤدي اصلا اي غرض. ده مش هينفع نهائي لانه معقد جدا واحنا ما عندناش مساعدة كافية. فهنا ايه شعور الطاغي على اللي بيتكلم؟ ashamed يعني حاسس بالخزى او العار، ولا negative سلبي؟ بالضبط negative. Number six, this is great. I really love it. Everyone should try it. هنا enthusiastic يعني حماسي، ولا suspicious يعني حاسس بالشك؟ بالضبط enthusiastic. Okay. طيب في number F اتفقنا انها مش هتيجي معانا في الكونتنت بتاع الصفحة دي، فاحنا هنستبعدها من الجزء الخاص بـ page 2. تعال نشوف مع بعض، نقلب سريعا لـ page 77. واتكلمنا في page 77، اتكلمنا في page 77 انها بداية مجموعة من الـ passages او مجموعة من فقرات القراءة اللي هيجي وراها مجموعة من الأسئلة، وإحنا محتاجين إن إحنا نذاكر الأسئلة كويس جدا جدا للامتحان. تعالوا نقرأ مع بعض الفقرة كاملة. الفقرة في page 77. A taste of America. Every country is proud of its national cuisine. Cuisine يعني أسلوب طهي. Which tells about its history and character. اللي بيقول كتير عن تاريخها وشخصيتها. England has its fish and chips, while Austria has its Wiener Schnitzel. Meanwhile, America has its hot dog? No. American cuisine is not just hamburgers and hot dogs. It's actually quite diverse. Diverse يعني متنوع أو مختلف، وهيسألني عليها في الأسئلة من وراء طالما هي محطوطة ببولد أو بلون أسود غامق. Every region in the United States has its own distinctive cooking traditions. Two interesting regions are New England and the Deep South. Both have similarities and differences in regard to بخصوص native foods, cultural differences and methods of cooking طرق الطهي. وبيكمل معانا في الباسج الثانية لحد ما نوصل لل الجملة اللي بدأ فيه both regions المنطقتين make use of native plants, seafood and جام. وهيسألني على جام اللي هي بمعنى لحوم الصيد أو لحوم الحيوانات البرية. That were introduced to the early settlers by the Native Americans. The native plants include corn, berries, nuts, beans and squash. اليقطين. People used these plants to make dishes such as cornberry, hominy and berry pies. Both regions also have abundant seafood. Abundant يعني غزير أو كتير. On land, wild turkeys are plentiful in both areas, so turkey is quite popular. Pork dishes are also popular due to an abundance of pigs. New England and the South had similar influences on their early cuisine. In both regions, dishes made from corn, beans, and potatoes were borrowed from the Native Americans. Also, the natives love to flavor foods with maple syrup. So both areas tend to like sweet foods. Both areas were also strongly influenced by the British, who loved rich, heavy foods such as their meats and puddings. Another similarity between New England and the Deep South is their method of cooking. Due to the British influence in both regions, food is often cooked in the old English way of steaming and boiling. In New England, people often prepare one pot meal like casserole and stews, اللي هي اليخنة. ممكن نقول يعني huge cuts of meats في one pot cooked for hours that take hours to cook. Page 78. Similarly, in the South, meats and fish stews are cooked all day. Baking is also popular in both regions. Although there are similarities between New England and Southern cuisine, there are also differences. The South has a warm climate and fertile soil, while New England has frigid winters and rocky soil. Southerners enjoy a variety of green, leafy vegetables, as well as sweet potatoes and rice. These plants can grow only in warm, wet areas. On other hand, New Englanders grow barren squash and potatoes that need a long, cold winter. They also have cranberries, blueberries, and apples, while Southerners have persimmons, pecans, and peaches. Both regions have abundant seafood. New Englanders eat cod, lobster, and clams, whereas Southerners have crayfish, shrimp, and crabs. There are also differences in cultural influences. In New England, the first settlers were the Puritans, a religious group who lived strict lives and ate plain food. Therefore, much of the food in this region is quite basic and mild. In contrast, the cuisine of the Deep South was influenced by the African slaves, as well as the French settlers in Louisiana and the Spaniards to the south. Creole foods combine ingredients and cooking methods from these three groups. Foods such as jambalaya, a seafood and rice dish, and shrimp creole are flavorful and spicy, whereas the New England boiled dinner is bland, يعني ملوش طعم, and plain. Finally, there are contrasts in cooking methods. While baking and boiling are shared by both regions, the South adds variety with their love of frying and barbecuing. Although everyone knows that fried chicken is practically a staple food of the South, يعني تقريبا طعام واحد ورئيسي في الجنوب, the truth is that Southerners fried just about everything, including pecans. وبيختم الفقرة إن America is a vast land with many different climates, geography, and histories of settlement. Though Americans share a love of many similar foods, على الرغم من أن الأمريكان بيشتركوا في حبهم لطعام متشابه, there are also some unique dishes. هناك بعض الأطباق الفريدة that are popular in each region, اللي مشهورة في كل منطقة. Chinese food on the west coast, في عندنا الطعام الصيني في الكوست أو الساحل الوست, and Italian in the east, والعكس في الشرق. Mexican food in the southwest and German food in the midwest. This makes the United States a very interesting place for traveling and getting a taste of its cuisine along the way. تعالوا نشوف مع بعض الاكسرسايز اللي في page 79. A vocabulary in context. What are the meaning of the bold words? Circle the letter of the best answer. Every country is proud of its national cuisine. Cuisine يعني اسلوب طهي, فالإجابة هي C, style of cooking. 2. American cuisine is actually quite diverse. Diverse يعني متنوع أو مختلف, فالإجابة هي having many different kinds. 3. New England and the Deep South have similarities and differences in regard to, يعني بخصوص أو بشأن. الإجابة هي A, on the subject of. 4. Both regions make use of native plants, seafood and game. Game يعني لحوم الصيد أو البرية, اللي هي wild animals hunted for food. 5. These include corn, berries, nuts, beans, and squash. Squash اللي هو اليقطين, يعني a large hard vegetable. Number 6. Both regions also have abundant seafood. Abundant يعني غزير أو كتير. A great amount of. Number 7. Casseroles and stews that take hours to cook are popular. Stews اللي هي اليخنة, يعني meat and vegetables cooked in liquid. Number 8. The South has a warm climate and fertile soil. Fertile يعني خصب أو قادر إن هو ينمو يطلع كتير من النباتات, فالإجابة هي able to grow many plants. Number 9, the native England, the New England boiled dinner is bland and plain. Bland يعني عديم الطعم, without much taste. Without much taste. Number 10, everyone knows that fried chicken is practically a staple food. Practically يعني تقريبا, يعني almost. في exercise B, vocabulary building, زي ما اتفقنا في المحاضرة عندنا في 1 و 2 3 كلمة, كل كلمة محتاجين نحدد هي noun ولا verb ولا adjective ولا adverb, وهنشوف هنسيبها زي ما هي ولا هنغيرها في A and B. ف for example في A عندي الكلمة diverse. Diverse يعني متنوع أو مختلف. في A, the cuisine of America is not just hamburgers, it is diverse. هنسيبها زي ما هي adjective. في B, the A of American cuisine is mainly due to cultural influences. ها, اختلافية أو تنوع. فهنشيل الإي من كلمة diverse وهنحط ITY, the diversity of American cuisine. طيب رقم 2, influence. Influence يعني أثر أو تأثير. In the early days, native foods أثر على الكوزين الأمريكي. أثر على يعني influenced. في B, African slaves and French settlers were مؤثرين, يعني influential. هنشيل الـ E ونحط I, A, L. في رقم 3, الكلمة هي flavor. Flavor يعني طعم, وفي نفس الوقت هي مش بس noun, هي verb. Flavor يعني ينكه أو يطعم. ففي A, in comparison to Louisiana, the cuisine of New England is not مطعم أو منكه, يعني flavorful. هنحط آخرها F-U-L. في B, in the early days, people طعم أو نكه, هتبقى flavored their food with maple syrup for sweetness. Okay? طيب تعالوا نشوف مع بعض مجموعة من الـ exercises اللي في آخر الكتاب, وهي بدأ من page, تمام, هي بدأ عندي من page 100. تعالوا نشوف مع بعض page 100. فيها مجموعة كلمات أو مفردات هي عبارة عن أو بتدخل تحت سياق أو تحت نمط الـ synonyms. synonyms هي المترادفات, والمترادفات يعني هي كلمات ليها نفس المعنى أو بتؤدي نفس المعنى, لكن إحنا غالبا بيكون عارفين المعنى الدارج بتاعها أو الكومن بتاعها. يعني في number 15 في صفحة 100, صفحة 101 رقم 15, why did Gibson speak to us so scornfully؟ فالسينونيم بتاع scornfully اللي هي بمعنى باحتقار أو بازدراء هي disrespectfully. Disrespectfully. في رقم 16, he is hindering me in my work. Hindering me in my work. Hinder يعني يعطل أو يأخر. المعنى السينونيم بتاعها أو المترادف اللغوي بتاعها هي obstructing. Number 17, Tammy likes to hobnob with theatrical people. Hobnob يعني صاحب أو يخالط, يعني associate. Number 18, Kip flounders every time he tries to speak French. Flounders يعني يتلعثم ويحدث الكثير من الأخطاء. Makes lots of mistakes. Number 19, Holmes was a famous sleuth. Sleuth يعني محقق. محقق يعني detective. Number 20, as university students we carused on Saturdays. Carused يعني to go wasted, to drink heavily. فالإجابة هي drank heavily. Number 21, Horace is an avid reader of science fiction. Avid يعني متحمس أو حماسي, يعني enthusiastic. Number 22, what he told me was sheer nonsense. Sheer يعني from A to Z. 100% nonsense, يعني pure. Number 23. He tried several ways to atone for what he had done. Atone for يعني يعوض عن. يعوض عن يعني compensate. Number 24. Kent's statement about Senator Jones was a rash one. Rash يعني متسرع, سريع. Hasty and thoughtless. Number 25. The play will run 2 hours if we delete this scene. Delete يعني يحذف. يحذف يعني omit. Number 26. At the general's behest, the soldiers attacked. Behest هو أمر عسكري يعني command. Number 27. The weather today is exhilarating. Exhilarating يعني مفرح ومبهج للغاية, يعني makes us happy. 28. When the actor forgot his lines, he muddled through to the end. Muddled through to the end يعني عدى للنهاية بسرعة, يعني jump to the end. 29. Tom hitched his trailer to the back of his car. Hitched يعني ربط شيء بشيء علشان الأولاني يجر التاني, يعني fastened. Number 30. Thompson began praying into the reasons why $500 couldn't be accounted for. Praying into the reasons يعني يتعجب أو يستغرب, يعني wondering. 31. Does Higgins seem ill-natured to you these days? Ill-natured يعني مش طبيعي أو مزاجه مش كويس, فهي مش unnatural ولا unwell, هي bad-tempered يعني مزاجه سيء. 32. Billy, it isn't polite to stare at people. Stare at يعني يحملق أو يحدق, يعني look steadily. Look steadily. ونقدر نقول إن ده شغل week 1 اللي هي كانت تقريبا ملخص لمحاضرة النهاردة plus الأسئلة اللي في آخر الكتاب اللي احنا ما اشتغلناهاش النهاردة, قلت أضيفها في الفيديو ده. إن شاء الله على قد ما نقدر نحاول نجمع أسئلة كتير بحيث ان يكون الاكزام as familiar as possible ليكم, with much exercise ان شاء الله. Good luck.